Hola!
Hola!
Bienvenidos a LightSpeed Spanish. This is videocast for early intermediate, and today we are talking about the present perfect and how to use it in with pronouns. Not in, but with. Not in, but with. Okay, so,
okay.
First of all, shall we clear up what the present perfect is? Just for, because you know, these names can confuse people.
Yes.
So the present perfect is, you know?
I do know. It's every time you see the word perfect, it means that you have the verb have, the auxiliary have. So haber.
Haber.
Yeah, haber.
That's not. Haber.
No, not that one.
That one.
The haber with an H and a V. So, if it's the present perfect, then it would be he comido, has comido, ha comido. So, have eaten.
I have eaten, you have eaten. So,
yes.
the present perfect is the have done something, have eaten.
Yes.
It's made up of the haber, as Cynthia says, which breaks down he, has, ha, hemos, habéis, han. Yeah, and then the past participle, which happens to be ado, ido in Spanish, apart from the irregulars.
Exactly.
Yeah, but typically, ado, comido, hablado, vivido. Yeah, so that's the present perfect, and we've got video casts about that from earlier. Okay, so if you want to just know a bit more detail about the structure of it, look back. Okay, but what we want to do is talk about how we use it with the pronouns. Because when the pronouns get involved, then it gets just a little bit more complex. Just a little bit, not much, just a little bit. So for example, if we want to, I have eaten is?
He comido.
Okay, so he comido. And if you want to say, I have eaten the empanada, okay, how would you say that?
Okay, I would say, are you asking how I would say or how I should say it now? Because I would say, me he comido la empanada.
Right, well, I'll tell you what, let's stick with that. Now, the reason that Cynthia's put the me on there is because here in Spain, when you eat something specific, when you name it, then you tend to use comerse rather than comer. Yeah, mm-hmm. So it becomes this reflexive. It's not reflexive in the reflexive, the way that we know it. What it is, it's a way that it's used for emphasis to show that you've eaten it all up.
Exactly.
Okay? You've eaten it all up. And it's always about specific food, not in general. Yeah? You don't say, you have to say, como cada día.
Yes.
You wouldn't say, me como cada día.
No.
Because they're not talking about food,
no.
Yeah?
Or if they say to you, ¿qué has comido? What have you eaten? ¿Qué has comido hoy? What have you eaten today? You would say, he comido verduras, legumbres, he comido pasta. Okay, you wouldn't say, me he comido. That would mean, in that sentence, you wouldn't say, me he comido. You would only say that when, if somebody says, ¿quién se ha comido mi chocolate?
Uh-huh.
Yes, yo me he comido tu chocolate.
Okay.
Yes. All right, who's eating my chocolate?
Well, let's stick
finished,
with that.
Or finished, no, my chocolate.
Let's stick with that. And so we've got this, me he comido tu chocolate, right? Now, tu chocolate, it's el chocolate. If we wanted to shorten that and say, I ate it, I have eaten it, better still because we're with the perfect tense, I have eaten it. So we need to convert el chocolate. What does that become?
So el chocolate is masculine, so it would turn to lo.
Okay. So what do we have to do? What structure do we do if we want to keep the me there, but we need to add lo?
So we would say me lo he comido.
Me lo he comido. How do you know where the me goes and where the lo goes? How do you know it's me lo and not lo me? Yeah? The reason that you know that is because we've got this thing called the rid rule.
It's never lo me, anyway.
Never.
In any tense.
No.
It's
but it's because
melo.
Of a rid rule, right? Which goes like this. Reflexive, indirect, direct. Okay? So in this sense, the me is the reflexive. It isn't reflexive. It's what's the word for the those verbs that have say on? In general, the overarching...
Never mind.
It's pronominal verbs.
Pronominal verbs, exactly.
Because it's got pronouns on them, okay? So it's a pronominal verb, which is the same as reflexive. So that goes at the front. And then the lo is direct, isn't it?
Lo is direct.
Innate.
Yeah, because it's a what. What did you eat? The chocolate. So that it's the direct.
So that's always... So it goes me for the R. And then it doesn't matter, you don't have to have all three pronouns, but you have to follow that order of reflexive and then direct.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah? So, me lo. So that's why it can never be lo me. Ever, ever, ever. Because it won't follow that order, yeah? What about this one, Cynthia?
Okay.
Okay. Have you told him the truth? Right?
Okay.
How would you say that one?
Le has contado la verdad.
Okay, so we've got a le. Now, to understand the le, you need to look at other video casts on the use of the indirect pronoun, especially the redundant use, okay? So, le has dicho la verdad.
O contado.
Le has contado la verdad, okay? So, la verdad is... There, if we wanted to shorten that and get rid of la verdad, it would convert into what?
So la verdad is feminine, so it would be la.
Okay. So that would leave us with, and now if we were following the rid rule, right? So we've got the le, which is indirect, right? Because that's referring to the person. And then you've got la, which is direct.
Le la.
Le la. So then it would be le la.
Le la.
He contado. Doesn't work. Why does it not work? You're not allowed to do Lela.
You can't do Lela. Or
because
Lelo.
You can't Lelo in Mexico or in any other Spanish-speaking country. Okay, I have to add that on. Or in any other Spanish-speaking country. You know why I have to add that on? Somebody said to me, great way of remembering the la-la rule. You can't Lelo in Mexico. And I thought, fantastic. So I started to say, you can't lay low in Mexico. And somebody sent me an email, just want to check. I know that in Mexico you can't lay low. But what happens if you're in Bolivia?
It's a good point.
Yeah, no, absolutely.
You know, some rules don't apply.
So then I started to say, you can't lay low in Mexico or in any other Spanish-speaking country.
Yes.
So any of the pronouns that go le are prohibited. What have we got to do, Cynthia? If it's a le.
So we have to turn the le into se.
Okay.
Se la he contado.
Se la he contado. Okay. And that's following. So sometimes people see that se and they think that's reflexive.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not. It's just an undercover le. And les is exactly the same. Les still converts into se. So it's just an undercover one. So what you have to do, you have to be a bit of a detective when you look at that sentence to think, is that reflexive, or is that actually a lay, you know, a say pretending to be a lay? No, a lay pretending to be a say.
That's it.
Exactly, yeah. Okay, let's do some more sentences. What about, have you done it?
Have you done it? Lo has hecho.
Okay. So the other thing about the perfect tense, when you add a pronoun, you will never ever split up has hecho.
Yes.
Those two things are stuck together. You'll never break them up. Okay, in English I think we can.
Have you done it?
So. Yeah. But in Spanish you can't. So the only place that the pronoun goes is before.
Mm-hmm.
Lo has hecho. And it can't go at the end. You can't say has hecho lo.
No.
Why? Do you know?
There are only three instances in which you can.
Very good, eh? You're right on the ball, Cynthia, eh?
Write the direct object pronoun at the end. One is the gerund, comiéndolo, viéndolo, pensándolo. One is the command in affirmative. So not the negative command. So hazlo, piénsalo, póntelo. And the other one, I've just forgotten.
Is the infinitive.
One. And the infinitive, of course. And when the verb is in infinitive. Pararlo, comerlo, beberlo, mm-hmm. pensarlo. So. Any other time when the verb is conjugated, it has to go before.
Okay. So, and just as an aside, the command, the positive command, the pronoun has to go on the end. There isn't an option. With the other two, there's an option quite often. You can put it at the front and at the back. Uh-huh. But with a command, it's always at the back. You cannot put it at the front. You can't say lo haz.
No.
It's got to be hazlo. Mm-hmm. There's no option, yeah? So, in the same with this sentence, and I can't remember, lo has hecho. Because we've conjugated that verb,
hecho,
there's nothing you can do.
Hecho lo, no.
Okay.
So lo has hecho, it have you done, or it you have done.
Mm-hmm.
So because in English you have to alter the sentence for people to know it's a question, because you don't have question mark at the beginning.
Yeah.
Yes?
Uh-huh. Yeah,
so
yeah.
If you see have, then you know it's a question. Have mm-hmm. you? Question. Okay? Because if it's too long and then you have the question mark at the end, you'll be finishing going, nah, 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 nah.
Skewing up, yeah.
So that's why you have the do, the have, the can at the beginning. Mm-hmm. We don't need to, because we have the question mark. So everyone knows when a question starts. So we don't have to alter the sentence. So lo has hecho, lo has hecho, lo has hecho. No difference whatsoever.
Mm-hmm.
So you have done it, or have you done it, is the same for us.
Yeah. So just to finish.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen. Señoras y señores.
Oh, damas y caballeros.
Okay. In Spanish, when you make a question, you put the question mark upside down at the front. And then one at the end, normal.
Do you know it's funny that you say upside down? Because for us, the upside down is the one at the end.
Really?
Yeah, because that one starts and this is the upside down.
Okay, wow.
Well, I suppose for people that watch up and down, upside down.
Careful with that finger.
It's this one,
right?
Not the other one. Because this one has the dot at the bottom, so it's the upside down one.
Oh, okay. Right, so the opposite to us. So that's what you're supposed to do. Now, if you've got any Spanish friends, you will notice that probably around about 80 to 90% of Spanish people now, when they are writing on, especially on text, don't bother doing it. They just stick it at the end. I think it's for speed. But we must.
It's for speed.
It's for speed, but we must, okay? Just because they miss it out, we can't.
Yeah, it's not nice. I don't like it, personally.
Well, Cynthia gets upset anyway.
I mean, upset. I'm saying that. I always put my question mark.
Cynthia always does. Always does. And she always makes sure I do as well. And I do now, always, because of Cynthia.
But thank you, honey.
But it's very important. You're welcome. It's very important for us to always do it the right way. Whenever you see Spanish people doing things that aren't right, they're allowed to. It's their language. They can do what they like. We can't. We've got to do it the right way.
And it's the only language in the world that has this.
Yeah.
So I think it's cool.
Yeah, yeah. So lots of languages are going to adopt it, but then they dropped it. Oh, rhymes.
Yeah.
Okay. I've been doing rhymes with my son.
Is this for free? They should pay for this. I mean, this is gold. What's it? This is gold, or this is gold?
This is gold, yeah.
This is gold.
Yeah. I'm giving them diamonds.
You're comedy here.
So it's because I've been doing rhymes with my son.
$1.99. Yeah.
I've been doing rhymes with my son, and so I've got rhymes going on my head. All right. Entonces, eso es todo. Y nos vemos en el siguiente videocast. Hasta luego.
Adiós.
Oh, perdón.
Oh.
Nos vamos.
Y nos vemos. Adiós.
Adiós.